Mina, Cone Bonnois, Jesus Freaking Gamer here, back with some exciting news. And this exciting news is applicable to everyone. This isn't a personal thing. Well, it is personal, but it applies to anyone who calls on the name of Jesus, I am pretty sure. I just listened to a song by a band called Disciple. It is in one of my top three favorite bands. They have been around for over a decade. They have always, always consistently proclaim the name of Jesus Christ. Never been ashamed to be a Christian band. Never been ashamed to give the gospel at the concerts that they sing at. They are a hard rock, kind of sort of metal band, more along the hard rock lines, and they're just solid as can be. I will leave a link to the specific video I'm about to refer to in the description below. Was just exposing myself to what to me is a new song. This is not a new song. I believe this is a few years old, actually, so I'm behind the times. Quite unfortunately, I pay a lot of attention to anime, and I pay a lot of attention to video games. So musically, it's like I've got music from several years ago. I usually just listen to that, and I'm perfectly happy with it. Every now and then, I try to stretch out and get something new. And recently, a friend of mine was like, "Yeah, you know that band Disciple?" I was like, "Yeah, I know those guys." They're like, "Well, hey, check out one of these songs. You know, I think you'll like them." So glad he did. And on this list of songs that he gave me, it's a song called God Is With Us. And as I was listening to that song, it hit me that victory is absolutely ours in the name of Jesus. If we are with God, we are guaranteed victory. Now, I know there can be a lot of questions if I make a statement like that, and I believe the verses that I'm going to say to justify this feeling I got from the song, I believe it will make more sense. Because the verses don't ignore the fact that, yeah, there's some bad stuff in this life. But it doesn't matter. As long as we maintain our faith in Christ, and as long as we maintain a repentant heart and a broken spirit before God, and we get and any sin we commit, we immediately get rid of, pretty much we're in good shape. We're going to be okay. God's going to see us through it. And here is, so all of this was really communicated just listening to the song. It's just like the thing that I'm going to be doing at some point here in the near future, which is a very big thing. And some God's called me to. I have been over the last several months, like, been preparing for it slowly but surely, been looking into various things, and God's been encouraging me, leading me, speaking to me. And in the song, I just got this impression. It was like a Holy Spirit moment where it was just kind of like ingrained in my heart. If I believe in God, and I believe He's with me, and I believe He's called me to do this, and if I'm right on all of these things, I really can't fail in the task that I'm going to do. I will succeed. I will be victorious, even though I go through some hard times. The victory is mine. I can't lose if I am in Him. And I try my best not to just let, you know, like when these thoughts come my way, it can absolutely be the Holy Spirit. It can absolutely be right. But I like to have Scripture behind it, and I do have Scripture behind this just amazing victory that is inevitable for me, and I believe for all believers who call on the name of Jesus. This is going to be somewhat popular for those who have been in church any length of time. It's Romans chapter 8, and I'm going to start at verse 31. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And I'm taking that, as of the song that I heard tonight, very, very literally. We are more than conquerors through Him who loved us through all these things. Through tribulation, distress, persecution, famine, nakedness, peril, even the sword, which essentially meant death. Even though for His sake we're killed all day long and are counted as sheep for the slaughter, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him. So I'm sure I'm going to be facing hard times where I'm going. I'm sure it's going to be a difficult task, and there are going to be several difficult days, maybe even weeks and months. It's a bit scary, I won't deny, but if God's called me to this, I can't lose. And if God's called you to do something, walk into it with a victorious attitude. Walk into it knowing you own this thing. Doesn't mean you know everything. Doesn't mean there aren't several life lessons that you still need to go through. Doesn't mean there aren't sins in your heart that still need to be repented of. It doesn't mean that the power that you currently have spiritually is enough, or the peak or the maximum. You need to grow in all of these things and continue to grow into Christ and the perfection that lies in Him. But whenever God's called you to something and you're walking with Him, if you keep your belief in Him and you keep repenting of your sins, I do believe a serious enough sin can collapse what it is God's trying to do. I do believe that based on various scriptural examples. But if you're walking with Him and keeping sin on the low down and making sure you repent, victory is inevitable through all of those things. So the name of the song is God is With Us. It's by Disciple. I'll leave a link to the official video. It's an official lyric video in the description below. Check it out if you have a few minutes, and hopefully this has ministered to you all. I'm glad to be bringing happy, fun times to these messages. It's a good feeling to be able to do this. So thank you very much for watching this video. I love you. God bless.